coming to you first. AutoTrader has done a lot of work looking at the roadmap and progress to date. What are your key takeaways?
Yeah, great question. And it's really topical at the moment, isn't it, with the new government and a potential change to the 2035 date. The key things that we found in our report this time around, and we always look when we do this report at what's happening with demand, what's happening with supply, and then generally what might be happening with some of the other barriers to EV adoption. And this time around, what we found is there are some slight upticks in demand just over the last month or so. That's been driven largely by manufacturer discounting behavior. They've really weighed in with some big discounts over the this year, and that has resulted in some slight uptick in demand as we go into the September plate change month. So there's some good news there. The main thing, though, and the focus of the report this time around has been what's going on in the used electric car market. It's really important, and this is really where it's pertinent to the fleet and leasing sector, because what we found is that essentially two stories have come about in the used EV market. First of all, electric cars that are kind of 3, 4 years old or older have reached price parity with ICE equivalents over the last. So there's been a big depreciation or a big value drop, as we've seen over the last couple of years. Lots of your viewers will have felt that themselves, of course. And now in the used market, those sort of 3, 4 plus EVs are selling quickly. Some of them are among the fastest selling cars in the market, so that's good news. They're turning quickly, so there's good news for the seller. The margins for the retailers are acceptable, and then of course the prices have reached a point where the economics work for the buyer. So sort of 3, 4 plus is good news. The finding really, or the analysis we've done, is kind of talking about how we got there. And of course, we've got to that position of price parity in 3, 4 because of the drop in prices from new to three. And that's really where the pinch point has been coming, because there's been more supply coming into that part of the market. And there's been a kind of supply demand imbalance at the moment. It's kind of okay, but the prices have been falling, of course. The last thing I'd add to that, when we look at the Road to 2030 report, is the behavior of those manufacturers coming back to the new car market. So yes, they're trying to stimulate retail demand by their discounting, but they are also using some more sort of push activity, more push behaviors that we've not seen in the car market probably since pre-pandemic, you know. But all of that stuff has kind of come back into play. What that's doing, things like pre-registration, is putting more nearly new cars into the market. And you've now got an issue where retailers have got nearly new stock, which they took on pre-registration, which is a bit more expensive than the new cars that they're being asked to sell. So for the consumer, the new car is actually cheaper than that nearly new car. And that's putting more pressure, of course, on the prices and the values of those nearly new cars, which then has a ripple effect through that cohort. So the big things for us are focus on used at the moment. That's a big part of the market, because of course it does drive new, it does drive residual values, and we're trying to get that information into the public domain to make sure people understand exactly what's going on, and they can start to put some pressure on policymakers as the government begins to review 2035.